Two roommates start a phone sex operation in our next comedic adventure. Hello to everyone watching and welcome back once again to RealScreenReviews.com. I am movie critic Nick Iacobucci, and our next movie review is For a Good Time Call. This tale opened in limited release on Friday, August 31st, 2012, and I think it opens to a wider release a week later, and it stars Lauren Miller, Ari Grainer, and Justin Long. This film comes to us from director Jamie Travis, a first-time filmmaker and veteran director of short films, music videos, and television commercials. This tale tells of a newly single Lauren that very much needs a place to live, and her mutually shared friend Jesse sets her up to live with his other friend Katie. The characters of Lauren and Katie actually know each other because of a not-so-friendly college incident from a few years earlier. Lauren then soon realizes that Katie makes a living as a phone sex operator and puts on hold a career search in order to help Katie manage her own phone sex line and business. Well, people, For a Good Time Call is without question one of the funniest films of the summer season, and the spoken dialogue is so rated R that it makes Seth MacFarlane's Ted look as if he was raised in a convent. But above and beyond all that, it tries and accomplishes things that would never even be attempted in a mainstream, big-budget Hollywood feature. Outside of the sex talk, what is spoken between the lead characters reminded me of sitting on my couch at home and listening to two of my friends converse, and almost every part of this film felt genuine in relation to the film's characters and behavior. While I was watching For a Good Time, it seemed to me that I was given a perfect blend of rogue independent movie making mixed with multiplexed finished product. Throughout the feature, the film never holds back for one inkling of 1 second, and what I mean to say is that it doesn't sugarcoat anything for the fear of being offensive. Now, at the same time, this film is put together rather well, the end result is nice and polished, and the acting is well above average. This takes me to the film's two leads that should really get a career boost with this feature. Lauren Miller and Ari Grainer shine bright as the two first mismatched roommates that soon come to rely on each other. I have always loved the adorable Ari Grainer and have always felt that she has been mostly wasted in films the likes of What's Your Number and The Sitter. Here she gets to let loose and embellish her inner sassiness, and all the while never loses her keen sense of likability. Then Lauren Miller brings a great contrast to the potty-mouthed Grainer, and her personality will be found as a welcome treat to anyone in attendance. Together they work as well as Newman and Redford, and the charm that they share together propels this film right along. You also have the usually likable Justin Long that is funny here but sometimes too much over the top, and as the shared gay friend is the reason that the girls come together in the first place. There are some other things that are worth mentioning as well. For one, the cameos of the men calling our roommates for help with their self-gratification were hilarious, and I'm not going to spoil them for anyone. Then Sugar Lynn Beard also lends her comedic talents to a film that's already a funny feature, and the well-written double entendres had me cracking up as well. On the flip side, I could see the graphic nature of this film being a deterrent for some to enjoy this feature, and this might work better as a girls' night out film rather than a date movie. For a Good Time also has pretty much a standard plot line that unfolds with relatively few turns and or surprises. Finally, some of the jokes that involve both sex toys and Lauren's parents seem to me to be R-rated sitcom material, and that humor fell one step ahead of Three's Company or Friends. At just shy of 90 minutes, For a Good Time was pretty much right on, and actually, I could have been a little longer and I wouldn't have complained a bit. You know, that's funny because one of the many insults that I hurled at The Apparition was its short running time, and this was only a few minutes longer than that film. This movie showcases the wonderful talent and likability of the two actors that have gone largely overlooked and lets them shine in what could be some of the raunchiest dialogue ever spoken in a film. I can say with almost certainty that this will draw countless comparisons to Bridesmaids, but I thought that this film had much more guts and never went into cliched territory or got overshadowed by its graphicness. Nick's Real Screen Review is a more than recommended 3 stars out of 4, and that's for the bold new comedy For a Good Time Call. Now, if you've enjoyed this review, please give a thumbs up below or click subscribe if you haven't yet already. I'm sure that I'll be returning soon enough with more movie news and reviews. And until then, remember, people, I'm not always right, but only when it comes to the movies. And thank you for your attention.